Adrienne Burgess, and welcome back to my kitchen for a new dessert devotion. I can't wait to share with you a new inspiring devotional and an easy dessert recipe. I'm going to show you how to make purple velvet cupcakes. We're going to start with a third cup of melted butter, 3 beaten eggs, and our shortcut, a box of white cake mix. And y'all, just like red velvet cake, we're going to add a tablespoon of cocoa powder and 1 1/4 cups buttermilk. And to get that purple color, I'm going to add pretty much an entire tube of purple gel food coloring. You use as much as you need to get the nice purple color that you want. Well, that was easy. Now I'm ready to put it in my cupcake tin. You're gonna bake these cupcakes on 325. Y'all, mine were done in 15 minutes, and yours may only need a minute or two more. Now that our cupcakes are in the oven, let us settle in for a time of devotion. For this devotion, I'd like to use as our focus the Gospel of Matthew, the passage in chapter 7, verses 7 through 11, where it begins, "Ask, and it will be given to you. Seek, and you will find. Knock, and the door will be opened to you. For everyone who asks, receives. The one who seeks, finds. And to the one who knocks, the door will be opened. Which of you, if your son asks for bread, will give him a stone? Or if he asks for a fish, will give him a snake? If you then, though you are evil, know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more will your Father in heaven give good gifts to those who ask him?" You may be wondering, what drew me or put the desire in me to make purple velvet cupcakes, right? It seems pretty random. It's something that I had never heard of before. I was looking for a purple recipe because I had this kind of tradition in our house where I like to make my son's birthday cakes from scratch, and they can come up with any kind of theme and I will do my best to oblige. We've done Batman, we've done green-eyed monsters, we've done chocolate lover cakes, we've done Halo, I mean, we've done dinosaurs, I mean, the list goes on and on. I think I did a Tuskegee Airmen cake. And so this year, my son has this favorite video game, and in the video game, there's this cool Jell-O car. Y'all, it's a 3-tier Jell-O car that they can drive around if you get to a certain level. He wanted this as his cake. The car was purple, and it was made of Jell-O. So I did lots of research on how to make a sturdy car completely out of Jell-O, and I used cake molds and tested it out and figured out how to make that part. Y'all, I went all out. I used fondant and cake dowels to make the wheels. And then I decided, do I serve a Jell-O mold at the birthday party? So I decided, of course, now I need purple cupcakes. So I came across this purple velvet cake recipe, and it was perfect because it was easy, because I already had to do the whole Jell-O thing and figure out how to stack and tier that. And then I could make this easy recipe that turns out perfectly. Trust me, it's very rich. It has this great cream cheese icing. Everything is purple. It goes with the purple Jell-O car, and all is well. I kind of chuckled as I went through the process because, you know, it's something that was in his head, and here I was doing my best to bring it to life. I relate that to the Gospel of Matthew because Jesus appeals to our desire as parents to entertain the desires of our kids. And he goes with those simple things like, you know, if your child asks you for a snack, if they ask you for a special treat, which was a treat back in the first century, right? A fresh egg, would you not give that to them reasonably? I mean, if you had it to give. And I could definitely see myself in that. Yes, if my kids ask me something special for their birthday, and I know I love to bake and I'd like to try that challenge to bring their idea to life, then of course, I would like to do that. Jesus said, remember that when you pray, that your Father desires to give you good gifts, just like you like to give your children good gifts. And guess what, Adrienne? You are not perfect. You are human, you are flawed, you have emotions, you have downfalls, you have shortcomings. As a parent, as a human being, as a person, as a mom, there are things that you will get right and that you won't get right, but you will do your best and you have those best intentions because you love your child. Imagine if you were perfect and holy. Well, guess what? You have a parent that is perfect and holy and loves you with unconditional love. Remember that when you pray. That would have meant a lot to those in the first century, where in the Roman Empire, there were lots of gods. And a lot of these gods, they were not perfect or holy, and they certainly didn't offer unconditional love to the people who worshiped them. In fact, many of the gods that people worshiped were seen as temperamental, that you had to constantly appease and supply with gifts and libations to keep them on your side. Those gods were tricksters. Some of these gods were known as being mean or vain or selfish or fickle. So they were on edge as they were constantly appealing to these false gods. And Jesus says, the God in heaven that I am speaking of is not like that. My Father is perfect and holy and loves you unconditionally and wants to give you good gifts. It's not only good for the first century, y'all, it's good news for us. That when we come to God in prayer, we can just bear ourselves, we can be ourselves, we will be received as ourselves, and let God know our desires. Go into the presence of God in prayer and be comfortable in being the person that God created you to be and bear your soul with the one who loves you the most. And trust that God is not there to punish you in your prayers or to judge you in your prayers, but it is a safe and sacred space for you to be real and to be open, to be honest, to be raw, right? To bear yourself fully and to be fully known by a holy God. I hope that encourages your prayer life, that you don't have to be perfect. You don't have to say it exactly the right way. You don't have to worry about getting it wrong. Come with a pure heart, open hands, open hearts, and open yourself to the gift of prayer, knowing that the one who is listening loves you unconditionally, wants to hear from you, and desires to give you good and perfect gifts. Amen. While my cupcakes are cooling, I'm going to make the cream cheese icing with a stick of room temperature butter and a softened package of cream cheese, to which I'm going to add a teaspoon of vanilla extract, half a teaspoon of lemon extract, and a tablespoon of powdered buttermilk. From there, I'm going to add about 6 cups of powdered sugar. How much sugar you want to add will just depend on how stiff you want your cupcakes. Then my extra step is to make purple icing for my purple velvet cupcakes that go along with my, well, purple Jell-O car perfectly. As you bless your loved ones in the kitchen, remember how much more our Heavenly Father is good to us. Thanks for joining me. For more sweet devotions, check out DessertDevotion.com.